For today's little adventure, you're going to be reading I Am George Washington. I Am George Washington by Brad Meltzer, illustrated by Christopher Theophilus. I Am George Washington. You know what one of the hardest things in life is? Being the first. When you're the first to try something new, there's no one to show you the way. But when I was little, I wasn't the first. I was the fourth of nine children. That's a lot of brothers and sisters. How do you think I learned to deal with people? In fighting. When I was really little, I lived at a place called Mount Vernon, which had a huge river running through the backyard and unexplored forest in every direction. At 5 years old, this was the world I knew. If you wanted to explore the forest, you had to be the first one to go inside. Think you're brave enough to go in there, George? Not yet, but soon. People will tell you that I was a perfect boy. They'll say I didn't tell a lie after I chopped down a cherry tree, but the cherry tree story isn't true. Like most boys back then, I liked swimming, fishing, and riding horses. I was a decent athlete, but nothing spectacular. Mostly, I was an ordinary kid. I liked books and even liked to dance. It was great. I was great at it. In school, my best subject was math. I was pretty good at writing, but I was also a terrible speller. You spelled beginning wrong, and harvest, too. Don't you realize I'm going to be one of the world's best leaders? I believe that almost as much as I believe you're a great dancer. But remember when I said that it's hard to be the first? It's easier when there's someone showing you how it's done. This is my brother Lawrence. He was 14 years older than me. No one had a bigger impact on my life. What are you wearing? My military uniform, so I can fight for a country. You like it? It's amazing. I loved hearing the stories of his adventures. Thanks to my brother, I knew I wanted to serve in the military. Soon, though, I saw how uncertain life could be. When I was 11, my dad died. We couldn't afford proper schooling, so my brothers had to teach me at home. I didn't go to high school or college, but I was committed to learning and building myself. You spelled it wrong, then I'll do it again. As a boy, I copied all the rules from a book of virtues. There were 110 in all. Number 1, don't gnaw your nails. Number 12, don't stand too close to people when talking or you'll spit on them. Number 100, don't use a fork or knife to clean your teeth. Instead, use a toothpick. The most important was the first one. Every action done in company ought to be done with some sign of respect. Guess that one covers spitting on the people too. When I turned 15, my brother told me I needed to get a job. Since I was good at math and precision, I became a surveyor, someone who explores large areas of land to find their boundaries. At 16, I went with a wealthy family called the Fairfaxes to survey the Blue Ridge Mountains in the Shenandoah Valley. There were no roads. The rain was fierce, and one night the straw mat I was sleeping on caught fire. The next night was even harder, but we kept going. Don't give up. There was something special in treading a new path, something beautiful in doing what no one had ever done before. Just being around the Fairfaxes changed my life. They helped me get work. I observed how they lived, how they dressed, and how they ate. I even learned how to properly dance. At the Fairfaxes, I ate with fine silver and beautiful china. At home, I ate with sticks at a fire. It was as if I was living in two worlds, but to me, both were equally important. You know you can eat with the rich folks every night. Yes, I know. When I got older, I joined the military. In my first big battle, I was on the British side, fighting against the French and Native Americans. I was nearly shot 4 times. 4 musket balls ripped through my clothing, but nothing could stop me. While others were screaming, I raced across the battlefield, keeping people calm. We lost the battle, but I became the commander of all the Virginia's fighting forces. At the age of 23, I ran for office to be a member of the House of the Virginia Legislature. I lost. That's right, I lost. Next time, I'll be better organized. It didn't stop me. I tried again, and this time, I won. In fact, I won re-election every time after that, but the world as I knew it was about to change. Remember when I was growing up, the United States didn't exist yet? Back then, there was no states, just colonies, all of them controlled by England. We were ruled by the British king, named George III. The king is unfair. He wants us to pay more for everyday things like stamps and tea. We deserve to be free. In April of 1775, the first shots were fired in Massachusetts, in Lexington and Concord. It took 8 days for the news of this new American Revolution to reach me. Are we going to let the colonists in Massachusetts fight alone, or are we going to join them? It was one of the biggest questions in history. The answer came in a meeting called the Second Continental Congress. Our 13 colonies decided we would fight together against King George III. All we needed was a leader for the battle. Guess who they chose? You look like you're in charge. Some say it was because I was a natural leader. Some say it was simply because I was taller than everyone else. But let me tell you a secret. I was the only one wearing a military uniform. It wasn't an accident. On the day I came ready to lead, ready to do the job, ready to be the first. Was it easy to be in power? Never. Our side didn't have enough food, clothing, or weapons. Their side was well-fed and well-armed. Our side didn't have trained soldiers. We were farmers and fishermen. Their side was the greatest fighting force in the world. In the winter at Valley Forge, some of our troops didn't eat for days. They wore rags and had to go barefoot in the snow. So how do we win? We were smarter. We wrote plans in invisible ink so the British couldn't read them. Cool, right? Invisible ink. My code name was 7-Eleven. Secret room 7-Eleven. We were sneakier. We launched surprise raids like the one where we crossed the Delaware River. But most important, we wouldn't give in. They were fighting for a king. We were fighting for a cause, for freedom. Also, let's not forget, we had a weapon they never have. We had General George Washington. After the British Army, a new government was formed. I presided over the convention that wrote our Constitution, which created the new laws for our country. The brand new United States of America was free to explore its own future. Now all we needed was to pick our first president. Someone brave, someone strong, someone trustworthy enough to handle all that power. Again, guess who they chose? You know, you're so popular, we could have made yourself King of America. Yes, I know. Some say it was my most heroic act. Instead of putting myself first, I put my faith in my country and I put my faith in you. At the end of the American Revolution, King George III asked someone what Washington planned to do after the war. The king was told that George was going to return to his farm. If he does that, King George said, he will be the greatest man in the world. And that's exactly what he did. And he did it again when he left the presidency after his second term. In life, there are many ways to lead. You can be a quiet leader, a tough leader, a bold leader. But leadership isn't about it being in charge. It's about taking care of those in your charge. When you're in a position of power, always look out for those who put their faith in you. And always forge your own road. Because sometimes the most important trail is the one no one has ever taken before. When you do those things, you will clear a path that will lead way for others. Every year we celebrate his birthday. President's Day is a national holiday. He's got the only state named after a president. He was even on one of the country's first postage stamps. People think he wore a wig, but he never did. He powdered his hair white, which was the style back then. I just like that he wore fake teeth. They were made of wood. They weren't made of wood. They were ivory. Gross. You can see them at Mount Vernon. Leadership doesn't come from charisma or personality. It comes from courage. The courage to do what's right. The courage to serve others. The courage to go first. I am George Washington. Today, they call me the father of our country. I have the courage to do what no one's done before. I hope I shall always possess virtue enough to maintain the character of an honest man. George Washington. There's a picture of him. There's a massacre's face upon his death. There are his teeth. And that's Mount Vernon, George's home. So he was born February 22nd, 1732. His father died in 1743. He joined the Fort Hux in 1748. His brother Lawrence died in 1752. The French and Indian War was 54 to 63. Married Martha Dandridge Custis on January 6th, 1759. The Battle of Lexington, 1755. Named Commander-in-Chief, 1755 in June. Crossed the Delaware River in 1776. British Governor of Yorkshire in 1781. Inaugurated as first president in 1789. Died at age 67 in Mount Vernon, Virginia in 1799. President's Day established in 1885. The end.